Hi, this is Daniel.
And this is JT.
And the purpose of this video is to speak to you about where to go after departing the Jehovah's Witnesses.
You're listening to The Critical Thought, where we challenge our listeners to use critical thinking when examining the teachings of Jehovah's Witnesses.
JT, talk to us, bruh. Where do you go? We get that question all the time. In fact, when we were both in the organization, well, we would see yellow lights, red lights, and we'd be thinking, yeah, there might be some yellow lights and some red lights, but where do you go?
Yeah, that's a great question. In fact, that's probably one of the biggest questions we get asked. You know, so where do I go now? Where do I go now? And I always tell people when we talk to people, the basic premise is flawed. As a Jehovah's Witness, we were always taught, if you do not accept what we say in our publications and in our magazines, then you have left God. Mm. Well, that's the basic problem. Mm. People haven't left God. Mm. That's the problem. So where are you going is not the question. I haven't gone anywhere. Ah. You know, the Watchtower had someone who asked that very question. If a person believes in God and Jesus and the blood of Christ and the Bible and the teachings, but they don't believe what the Watchtower says, why is it y'all treat them so badly? Right. And that was the whole point. And it was just interesting how the Watchtower tried their best to explain, well, basically, if you don't agree with what we wrote, then you left God. Mm-hmm. And so that is the flaw in that question. Mm-hmm. People are not leaving, going anywhere for the most part. Mm-hmm. People I know, they still have the same value system. They believe in that. They recognize that we're someone larger than us. Mm-hmm. So people have basically the same views and features that they've always had. But it's the way the Watchtower presents it.
So you say that it's a false premise, where do we go from here? Where do we go after leaving? That you can leave the organization and remain with God.
That's the whole point. And that's the fallacy that the Watchtower has very skillfully. I mean, they have skillfully done this. In fact, it's interesting when you look at the scripture that the Watchtower actually uses. They refer to a conversation between the apostle and Jesus. Well, Jesus didn't ask him, the question wasn't, where am I going? It was, to whom am I going to? And when you have a group of people who write and publish something, I mean, it's got to be the greatest ego trip in the world to be a writer and to tell people that if you don't agree with me and what I write, you have left God. And then turn around and say, well, we don't write nothing inspired. And we don't write anything infallible. How do you get to say, I'm writing something that's not inspired, something that is not infallible, and yet if you don't agree with me, you left God. And that's what, you know, and that goes back to what our whole theme of our site is about. Mm. Thinking critically. That makes no critical thinking sense at all.
No, it doesn't.
Yeah.
That's an aha for me, JT.
Yeah.
Right, I hadn't thought about it that way, that it's a false premise. Where do we go after leaving the Watchtower? And the premise that you're leaving God, you can actually leave the organization and remain with God.
Yeah.
And that the Watchtower itself will say, well, we're not writing on behalf of God, but yet if you leave us, you're actually leaving God.
That's exactly.
And your point is, that ain't critical thinking.
That's not critical thinking.
But if you slow down to speed up, if you slow down, you think on paper, you ask yourself the tough questions, you melt that iceberg, mm-hmm. you come to that conclusion.
Yeah. One of the things I will often tell people, and I think this is very important to understand, people in this organization, they have been spiritually abused. And so I often ask people, because people say, well, what denomination should I join now? What church should I join? And I often tell people, and it goes back to what we always say, the first thing that you got to take care of yourself. Let me give you an example, Daniel. If you had a friend who was in a long-term relationship with someone for many years, and this person was abusive to them, and you had been telling them, you need to leave. You can't let them keep abusing you like that. And so finally you get that phone call one day, and the person says to you, I did it today. I left them. Now, would you say to that person, I'm going to stop by and see you this afternoon, and I got this friend I want you to meet? No. Why would you not introduce them to a new relationship and they just left the one they were in?
Not ready.
They're not ready. And so that's why I tell people, when you leave the organization, when you leave this denomination, just like when people leave a relationship with another person,
a marriage, whatever,
whatever, The last thing you really need to be doing is getting right back, jumping right into something else. Take your time. Work on yourself first. And we have observed basically two things happen for people when they leave. There are those who, just like in a regular relationship, they back up, they give themselves time. And what they end up doing is that then they decide, I want to get involved with something. I want a new relationship with someone now. And they will perhaps start dating or getting involved in someone for a new relationship. And then there are individuals who they leave a relationship and they said, I'm good. And so we have seen both happen to people who've left the organization. Some leave in over a period of time. They may be, again, once involved with a religious group or religious denomination. And then there may be those who they decide at this time, not right now.
So the reason I'm smiling is because you're giving me another aha, which is some remain single.
Some remain
single. And are hampered with their singlehood. And some decide to get remarried to another religion.
That's true.
But in either case, what you're saying is, and we all can relate to this, you need to take some time to work on yourself. Mm-hmm. And like a real relationship, whether it was a marriage or an engagement that got broken off, you want to take at least 6 months, a year. It varies for different people. And then decide, do you want to remain single or do you want to go to another organization? But your point is, you can remain single and still remain with God.
Yes.
For the rest of your
life. For the rest of your life.
It's outstanding. Okay, so in summary, the question was, purpose of this video was to talk about where do you go from here? We've all heard that question in the organization. JT is saying, based on his experience, you don't go anywhere from here. You stay with God. You can leave the organization and remain with God. That it's a false premise, the question itself. And that when you get underneath the iceberg, the reality is that the organization is saying, we ain't really writing on behalf of God. But if you leave us, you actually leave in God.
Yeah.
Any closing comments, Coach?
I just tell people, just take your time. We have been literally spiritually abused as Jehovah's Witnesses. We were living in fear. I've seen so many videos. I've talked to so many people, both myself and my wife. People are breaking down emotionally, just as if they were in a relationship with another person who was mistreating them.
Quick, is it a little strong to say spiritual abuse? I mean, bruh, that's heavy language.
And that's really what it is. We did a video called The Fog, Living in Fear, Obligation, and Guilt. And what you will find is those three things, they take place in any relationship that you can have with individuals, groups, organizations. The impact on the person is the same. Pain is pain.
Spiritual abuse, lifting the fog, becoming clear. You can remain with God and leave the organization. This is Daniel.
This is JT.
All right, we'll see you on the next video.
This program was sponsored by Critical Thinkers.